AF is considered part of the Pi system. As you can see here, we describe it as an integral part. Now, what's not pictured here, though, is the activity of SQL Server. As we'll discuss in more detail later, SQL Server ends up being an important component, primarily just for storage purposes, but SQL Server is a component that we require with AF. Now, let's take a look at what this looks like if we actually look at a typical Pi system that's using AF. Now, in this case, we've got three components described in this diagram. And it's the three major components of AF. They're the AF client applications, the AF server, and a copy of SQL Server that contains the AF information. We've got it labeled there, AF SQL Database, but this is just regular Microsoft SQL Server. I'm not talking about anything that comes from OSI here. That's a copy of SQL Server that happens to have a database on it that we use in AF. So here's how it works. The clients are those applications that use our AF SDK, our software development kit, to make requests for that AF structure that we saw in our Pi System Explorer. So if I can go back, bounce back here, you see these structures here. This is an AF client right here. This AF client is presenting to me this list of structures, and from here I can drill down and find the tanks, pumps, etc. that I'm interested in. Now, that AF client was making requests for information that is, in fact, stored in SQL Server. We use SQL Server as a mechanism for storing that structure that we just saw in the Pi System Explorer. The AF server's job is to handle all the security requests, or all the security for the requests between this client and this server, and also all the security and communication that goes on between this AF server and your SQL Server database, whether it's on this computer or some other computer. You can think of it like this. The AF server is the engine that's handling all the requests, all the security requirements, you know, when a client requires information about that AF structure that's been already defined. Now, the structure's been defined by those AF clients like Pi System Explorer, or by the other applications that may be using our AF SDK to create that structure. The structure's stored in SQL Server, plain vanilla Microsoft SQL Server, but it's the AF server that's handling all that communication, all the security requirements, etc. Now, there's a big gap in what we've discussed so far. Okay, so we've got a client that's making requests to get data or to navigate to specific nodes within that tree structure that we just discussed. Where's Pi come into all this? When do we actually see some Pi data? As you can see, the Pi servers are represented down here. Well, as I mentioned earlier, when a user finally gets to the part of the system he's navigating to, either using this tree structure or using one of the search mechanisms that we have available in ProcessBook and our other clients that are AF aware, when he gets to that data, that's the point, and that's the only point at which there's really a need to get to the Pi system. So as a user is traversing through this tree structure, he's really just dealing with this AF SDK, the AF server, and SQL Server. It's only when he starts, you know, grabbing those Pi tags that the Pi gets involved at all. Once he gets those Pi tags and starts retrieving their attributes, etc., in their data, that's when Pi gets involved. Now, I don't want to leave out the fact that the destination of a user who's traversing through this tree structure to find data, that destination may actually be data that comes from some other data source. So it could be some non-time series data source, like a relational database or a manufacturing execution system, or some other, you know, relational database type data. Okay, well, this was an illustration in which we have both the AF server and SQL Server running on the same computer. Let's take a look at a structure in which we have the AF server on a different computer than the SQL Server database. It's not very different here. All you're really noticing is that this copy of SQL Server is on a different machine. This can be, you know, in the same room, or it could be half a continent away. All we need is access to some copy of SQL Server, because that SQL Server serves as the repository. That's what this little disk icon means. It's a repository for the things that are being organized within AF. So all those structures that are defined, all the relationships being defined between the different elements in AF, that information is stored in SQL Server. Now, technically, it's actually possible to put all of this on one computer, the PI system, the AF server, and the copy of SQL Server. We don't recommend that for anybody that has more than, say, hundreds of elements in AF, maybe up to 1,000. But there is no, other than the resource constraint, there's really no problem with organizing all of this onto one computer. So what types of things does this design allow us to do? Well, one of the things that happens is that these AF clients here, you will notice, when they connect to this AF server, they're not connecting to PI at that point. They're just connecting to this AF server. The communication between this AF client here, like PI System Explorer or Process Book, the communication between that and your AF server is all handled through Windows Communication Foundation. So this is actually a Windows username and password you're going to be prompted for when you connect to this AF server. Also, you'll notice the AF server, it handles all of the communication with SQL Server. So this AF client, it does not need credentials to connect to the SQL Server. All that's being handled by the AF server. We just need to connect to that. The AF server does all the communication with this copy of SQL Server. Another thing is you'll notice that these AF clients can connect to more than one AF server at a time. I'd like to demonstrate this right now. I've actually got two AF servers available to me in my current network. If I look at this database option here under PI System Explorer, you'll see that I currently am connected to that server right there. That is a server called, it's NICGX280. It is an AF server. Did you notice the bullet or the balloon help there? It showed that I was connected as my Windows user. Now, I can't show you that now. Let's see if I can show you that again. Yeah, see, it says connected as OSI/NIC. Those are Windows credentials. Those have nothing to do with PI. So I'm connected with this client to AF using Windows credentials. Now, as you can see, there is a second defined server, an AF server. If I didn't know where that is, I could go ahead and actually create that by adding a new system and typing the name of my other server. I can actually add another server, but in this case, I just want to make the point that here is a second server. So on my first server, I have three tables, including this one called Training Sample. Look at this copy of AF. This is a different AF server entirely. Now, remember, the communication that we're going to see here, now let me go ahead and connect. The communication we're going to see now between my AF client and this AF server is a Windows communication. So, sure enough, I'm being prompted for my Windows username and password. And look what I have here. This is a whole different set of AF databases. There's Training Sample again, but all these other things are all from a different AF database. So as you can see, this AF client can connect to more than one AF server at a time. Yeah, there we go. Another interesting result of the design is that because SQL Server is really just used as a repository for the data that is configured in AF, this copy of SQL Server can host the information stored by many different AF servers. So it's not just one AF server per SQL Server. That's just going to be creating tables in SQL Server after all. So you can hook as many AF servers to that copy of SQL Server as are required. Now, if you're interested in building in redundancy to any of the components here, that's entirely possible. The AF servers can make use of Microsoft's load balancing software. So if you have multiple AF servers configured using Microsoft for load balancing, that's perfectly acceptable. We also support all the different options for SQL Server clustering, SQL Server mirroring, SQL Server replication, also load balancing. So all the different tricks you know from load balancing with SQL Server, you can exploit in this case as well. You can also, of course, make use of high availability to make the PI servers redundant. If some of this is still not making any sense, here's a real quick analogy I'd like to offer. It's an overly simplistic analogy, and it kind of falls apart in places. But imagine this. Imagine for a second, instead of making software for the last 25 years, let's say OSIsoft was in the business of making something else people like to consume instead of real-time data. Let's say we were making food. We were in the restaurant business. We had all these wonderful restaurants, and they were doing great, and everybody loved it. The problem was it was very difficult sometimes for people out here to find what they were really interested in. You know, maybe that didn't go across from one restaurant to another. Maybe it was just difficult. For whatever reason, they couldn't get there. Well, we took it on ourselves to address this issue. We said, you know what we need? We need some kind of a map, something that will allow people to find this great stuff that they really like and just do it easier. But it'll be more than a map. Sometimes people just want to look for things by category, so we'll build some kind of a search into this. We'll make it like a GPS so that people can search for certain types of food. Okay, we want Mexican food or Chinese food or what have you. So we'll make this a very wonderful index into those things that people want and even into the things that we don't make. I mean, we know there's sometimes people go to other restaurants. They don't necessarily want to get everything from us. And we'll allow this map here, this wonderful super GPS, to find whatever it is that you want to consume, whether it's our stuff, whether it's somebody else's stuff. Now that's what the AF server is like. It's this wonderful mechanism the AF clients can use to find exactly what you're interested in consuming. So now what role does SQL Server have to play in this environment? Well, SQL Server is the repository where we store all that map information. So for example, you know, when I have a list of addresses and the types of food that's served and all the other things that are associated with that, what the store hours are, etc., all that needs to be stored somewhere, so we're storing that in SQL Server. Now, I hate to make it sound like this is just, you know, like a memory card or something, but we are treating SQL Server like a black box. The AF server is handling all the communication, all the security between the clients and the AF server, and AF server is also handling all the communications to this, our storage mechanism. So we are treating that, or you can treat that like a black box, you as the user. Now to me, the greatest value of this analogy is when you think about the relationship between this super GPS here, you know, this thing we've constructed to help you find what you want to consume, think of the relationship between that super GPS and the restaurants themselves. Is there a relationship there? Well, this super GPS knows about these restaurants, but they're a completely separate entity. The restaurants don't even need to know that this AF server is directing people to this Pi server to consume. This is really just about completely separated from this. And that's why, that explains why, for example, there is an AF SDK, an AF software development kit, and a Pi SDK. Two separate, entirely different development environments, because when it comes down to it, you know, the AF clients are always talking to the AF server. And it's only once that AF client has delivered some information about this Pi server that now the Pi SDK has to get involved. So to wrap up this analogy, let's go back to what we're actually doing. No, we haven't been in the restaurant business for the last 25 years. We've been in the real-time data business for the last 25 years, and we think we're the best darn, you know, manufacturer of real-time data systems there is. But trying to get to that data, well, we'd like to make it as easy as possible. So what we've done is we've created this, AF. AF is a mechanism to make it easier for you as a user to create structures that will easily allow people to find what they're looking for, or create categories that will allow people to search what they're looking for without the navigation through the tree structure. Either way, we just want it to be easier for people to get to this great stuff that we've been, you know, serving up, we think, better than anybody else for years and years. Now, again, SQL Server, that's where we store all the stuff that you configure in here on the AF server. That gets stored over here. So that's my analogy. I hope it might be of some help.